Hi everyone, my name is Amir Mohammed Shafi and I'm here with our expert, Dr. Rodriguez. Some background information about me, I am a fourth year honors life science student at McMaster University, and today we'll be talking to Dr. Rodriguez about stem cells. So if you wouldn't mind, could you please tell us more about yourself?
My name is Veronica Rodriguez Moncalvo, in this case. I have been teaching the life sciences program, many different undergrad courses. One of them that is Life Sci 2A03, Research Methods in Life Sciences, which has a focus not only on research methods, but it does so with a focus or a theme that is stem cell research. On the side, I also supervise undergrad students, which do undergrad thesis on the field of stem cells, in particular using Hydra, an aquatic invertebrate organism that has a great capacity of regeneration. And therefore, undergrad thesis study the stem cells of Hydra in different conditions.
Professor, could you tell us what stem cells are?
Stem cells are specific type of undifferentiated cells that all organisms have that provide organisms with the capacity of regeneration, which means replacing damaged tissue, and also allows organisms to replace damaged cells that occur as a regular process that normal functioning of our organs and tissues.
I know you've introduced some information about your experience with them, but could you tell us more about your experience with working with stem cells?
Hydra has different type of stem cells, and we're looking into how stem cells allows Hydra to regenerate with that high capacity. Different ways in which students have been studying stem cells and the function of stem cells in Hydra is by exposing Hydras, for instance, to specific drugs and see how those drugs affect the regeneration or the replacement of missing tissues in Hydra.
Since you've been working with stem cells and have been doing stem cell research for a while now, what are some myths and misconceptions that you commonly hear from the general public surrounding the topic of stem cells?
That's a great question. I think one of the common myths about stem cells, when people hear about stem cells and the capacity of stem cells to replace missing tissues, probably many people wonder why stem cells are not used more frequently to cure many different disorders or human disease. The fact is that it's not that easy to work with stem cells. It's very challenging. There are many challenges that researchers working with stem cells face. And therefore, although ideally it would be great to be able to use stem cells to cure all kinds of disorders or human disease, is not as easy as one may think, given that stem cells are very delicate. They're not easy sometimes to isolate and grow in the lab. So those are some of those challenges that researchers that work with stem cells face.
So what are some examples of other research that are associated with stem cells? Maybe some human stem cells research? Like, what is the current world of research regarding stem cells?
That's also a great question. Researchers have been using stem cells, for instance, to screen, so to look for potential drugs that can be used as potential therapeutics for human disease. So using specific stem cells in the lab to treat those stem cells with these particular drugs to find a suitable drug that can be used as a potential therapeutic tool. Also, researchers have been using stem cells to better understand how organs and tissues develop. That's certainly one field of stem cell research that has been going on for quite a while now. And lately, as I mentioned before, stem cells can, if manipulated in a certain way, can be used to study or to model human disease.
So for the next question, what are your personal opinion or vision on the future that this research of stem cell can potentially take? For example, what are some of its implications? Will there be any more clinical use, or just where you see it going in general?
Yeah, that's an interesting question, and it's one that probably many of us are wondering. So as I mentioned earlier, researchers face many challenges when it comes to working with stem cells, especially when looking at the potential of the use of stem cells for what is called cell therapy, so the replacement of damaged cells in a human patient. These days, researchers have been looking into new ways and better ways to manipulate stem cells, either in the lab, in a little petri dish, or what we call in situ, in the living organism, so in this case, in the patient itself, to modify those stem cells in a way that could better replace those damaged cells without any potential side effects like tumorigenesis or any other kind of side effects.
Thank you, Dr. Rodriguez, for giving us this opportunity and this interview. That was a very informative and interesting topic and wonderful answer.